Hello everyone. In this video, we are going to study about exceptions in PLSQL. So what is an exception? Exception is an error condition during a program execution. Basically, an exception will disrupt the normal flow of the program. Whenever a program is being executed, it will disrupt the normal flow. It will throw some error which will be captured in the exception block. And the programmer can find out what the error was. Okay. So there are two types of exceptions in PLSQL: system-defined exceptions and user-defined exceptions, which is quite explanatory. System-defined exceptions and user-defined exceptions. So it is quite self-explanatory. So system-defined exceptions are created by the system. Basically, they are already defined by Oracle. Okay, and user-defined exceptions are defined by users, the programmer. Any sort of user-defined exceptions. Okay. So in system defined exceptions, there are a lot of them, like no data found, too many rows. These are just two, but there are a lot of system defined exceptions. Okay, so basically this is an example. Okay, so this is a program, declare tmp varchar. So basically tmp is a variable, and then in the begin block, and then there's going to be an end over here, which I forgot to write. So in begin, select g name into tmp from employees. Employees is some table, so basically we are selecting it and putting it in the variable tmp. And in exceptions, we will write when too many rows is already declared by Oracle. So you don't have to declare the exception. All you need to do is when too many rows, then what is supposed to be done. If this whatever query is between begin and exception, if this is throwing an error which is too many rows, basically too many rows are being thrown. So for example, this query, select gname into tmp from employees, as you can see, this query will select all the g underscore, basically all the names, because there is no where condition. So basically a lot of variables are going to be selected, and the query says it has to be put into tmp, which is a normal variable. So which is wrong, basically too many rows will be selected, so which is an error condition. So hence exception, when too many rows, then dbms underscore output dot putlin basically print any sort of error message. So here I'm printing error too many rows. Okay, you can print anything. Now the next thing is user defined exception, basically where the user defines an exception. Okay, so in this case, all you need to remember is for exceptions, you need to declare, then raise an exception, and then handle the exception. So let's see an example to understand it better. So this is an example. So here we are declaring again a variable, and then we are declaring an exception. So how do we declare an exception? Basically any sort of name, exp, as I've written here, exp, what is the type? Exception. So this is how we declare an exception. This variable is an exception. This is how we are declaring. What was the second thing? Raise. Declaration is done. Second thing is raise. So how do we raise? So whenever, so this is the begin block. Okay, begin, exception, and then end. Okay, so in begin we write the SQL query, whatever the logic is, whatever is there. So there is some any sort of select query, anything is there. Now some conditions. So for example, if tmp is null, then raise exp. So basically raise word is used over here. Okay, so raise exp. Exp is an exception. So this is how we raise an exception. Okay, any sort of query, any condition, if this is, then raise the respective exception. Now the third thing, first thing was declare, second thing was raise, and the third thing is handle. So how do we handle? In the exception block, what we write? When exp is the exception which we declare. So whenever exp will be raised, when exp, then whatever needs to be done. Okay, so what I'm going to do over here is I'm going to just simply print anything, any error message you want to print, you can print. But in this case, I'm just printing error word. Okay, dbms underscore output underscore line error. So this is what user defined exceptions are. All you need to remember is that in user defined exceptions, you have to declare an exception, raise an exception, and then handle the exception. Hope this video helped you, and thank you for watching. Goodbye.